Not a bad take today. Keep this up and Nassau will be the first city where men and women may live as God made them. Easy and free. All it takes is a few drops of blood, sweat, and a swatch of cloth.
We fly no colors out here. Praise the lack of them. So let the black flag signal nothing but your allegiance to man's natural freedoms. This one's yours. Fly it proud.
I will.
Hand over the docket I lent you. If we're to keep our republic afloat, we'll need guns as well as gold.
That means attacking the navy.
So long as they're flying King Philip's colors, we'll not offend our own monarch. As you've likely seen, the number of merchants roving these waters is 80 the number of military ships.
Aye, easy purchase, but in small doses.
Right. So to lure the navy out of hiding, it's best to cause a bit of mischief.
Catch a few small fish to attract the big ones.
That's right. So plunder and pillage as you see fit, Captain Kenway.
We're clear, Captain.
Good eye, man. Are you ready for this, Kenway? She won't go down without an honest fight.
Who's up for taking that brig, lads? Shout aye! That's a sound I like to hear. Pipe to quarters. All hands to cannon.
Careful around the navy. They're as likely to ram you as far as one side.
Test those powder barrels.
Good thinking.
Fire!
Captain Lance,
there,
she's gone!
Fire!
Fire!
Mudstains!
The poor old storm is dead and gone.
So be long, boys.
The poor old storm is dead and gone.
Aha! Reef the topsails and gather! Ground it all on!
Stormy alarm!
Fire! Fire!
Fire!
Fire!
Fire!
Fire!
Fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire!
That was a rumble, by God. How do we fare?
A fine purchase, no mistake. Now, I think it's time to lay low and drive our way back into secrecy.
Agreed. So, how do we get rid of this notoriety?
Money, my boy. A well-placed bribe to the right government official. See the military off your tail.
Right, let's do that. I'll need to meet these good Samaritans at some point.
Smart thinking.
Reef the topsails and gallant!
He's the main muzzle the gallants!
More sail! All sail!
What is going on, lads?
You need to vanish, friend.
Thank you.
wander, can we? You've a knack for this kind of work.
It ain't work if you love it.
But I ain't doing this forever, lads. Only until I get enough coin to buy some land and influence back home.
Jesus, will you listen to your tripe? Still dreaming on about that strumpet back in England when you could have any better you wanted here and now.
Ah, such lofty goals for you gents. And here I thought I was in the company of scoundrels. Fine purchase today. What's the crew's mood?
All smiles and no teeth. And there's a few talking about meeting with Master Kid to steal from a nearby plantation.
Plantation? That's ambitious.
Profitable too, if we can manage it.
Aye. It's a good idea. Why, look. It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that had earned you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him. And he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Who's there? Yes, yes. He traded prices, but knows are fair. And with a quality he knows is sound.
Aye, it's hearty molasses and raw cane. That's a given.
It gladdens me to hear your saying so. Despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment.
speak more softly of what we have to do. Less than a voice talking should make a pleasure rue. The streets, they are so nigh, love the people.
Burford, Manning, to me. Done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. It's a good harvest this year.
You might not talk so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly port, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation. We came to quite an understanding. As you see, sir. All right, boys. We're going home.
Captain, you have the look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Ade. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there. And it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Party like!
Hold on, there's trouble afoot.
I see them.
Ghost the gallants and royals!
Starboard!
Every last scrap of duck on the wing!
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantation, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked a plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a high price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers that crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it's time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in Thatcher's Mill of Copper. Let me tell you, brother. Boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin, stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus. It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation could catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackdaw.
Haul hearty, lads! Furl those mains!
What's happened here? Why such disarray?
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty?
It's no bother, sir. We have everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed. By pirates, if my eyes honor me, though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
For God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about, you'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh?
The key, goddammit! Someone find me the key!
Make haste. You've another load after this.
Is there no one over here?
Fetch me the warehouse key, if you please.
Snails. Faster, ladies. Don't leave till it's done. Careful with that, you dullard. Move on. Fire snails.
You.
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, free, and out of the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Jackdaw handles nice. Pinchster from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil love a hurricane. Might have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way.
That ship's a monster. Look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
Under cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may come to that.
Stands out! Let's get moving!
Charles. Reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours.
Not a man I'd call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect the man.
Look, they fire mortars, Captain!
Loose all and trim sharp to the wind!
Floating booty there for the taking, sir.
Trim the yards off the wind.
Douse those gallants. Haul.
Crowd it all on.
I'll roll along. Man your sheet. Mortars, Kenway.
Reef in all top.
Charles Vane, slinking off with his tail between his legs. That's good news for us.
Bleeding bastards! We'll have to deal with this skirmish fast. Forget the galleon and send these interlopers to hell!
Sailing for that island.
I know the place. Natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian de Cas, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on. Maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Aye!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
Thank you.
Podemos escapar!
Quiero hablar contigo.
Remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fils de pute! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp.
I'm sorry about this, mate. But I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Boukenyi. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue.
What's this?
His petty larceny, the extent of your ambition. Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth, abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you. Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.
The cove is ours!
I just saw you were logging out, so I thought I'd stop by and give you something. A little welcome gift. We give awards to our top-notch employees for doing quality work. And they're nice to have, since there's no official bonus scheme here. I already have about 11 or so. Oh. Bonjour. Of course. I'll pass it on. Well, looks like Olivier wants to meet with you. It's exciting. Follow me. It's on the top floor, so it's not hard to find. But the rest of this building can be confusing to first-timers, so we had the tools team whip up a great map application. Check your communicator. I added a waypoint to Olivier's office. Should be easy to find. Olivier's a nice guy. He won't bite.
Scotty of this Abstergo Enterprise, in charge of all the tech stuff. Do you have a minute? Damn it. The tracker says you're on your way to Olivier's office. All right. I'll ping you when you're done. I have a favor to ask.
Bonjour. Go right in. He's waiting for you.
Well, unless you are specifically ordering me to abandon it, I won't jeopardize our flagship project. Edward Kenway is the... But this is how Hollywood got its start, right? With pirate movies. Douglas Fairbanks, Errol Flynn, and now we have access to the real deal.
Exactly. We'll talk about all that together at the shareholders' event. Right. Looking forward to seeing you too. Take care, Lizia.
Salut! Hi! Thanks for coming in. I know you're busy. So, I review some of your data. Pretty raw stuff. Obviously, we need to scrub off some of the dirt to make it family-friendly. Maybe give Edward a voice like James Bond or something. More of a ladies' man. A beautiful city, no? So the main reason I asked to hear concerns something called the Observatory. It's been mentioned a few times in the footage you found. I'd like to encourage you to focus on locating this specific set of memories as soon as possible.
If it were up to me, on s'en crisse. I wouldn't bother.
But some bigwigs at Abstergo Industries have been hounding me for days. So, follow whatever leads you find, and hopefully we can... Oh, incoming call. I have to take this. We'll keep in touch. Bonne journée. Alan, bonjour.
Oui, 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 tout va bien. Naturellement.
Hi, John from IT again. You got a second? Good. I'm adding a waypoint to your map. So, a colleague of yours left for vacation this morning and forgot to send a video file she promised me. Since I hate just about everyone else on your floor, I was hoping you could help me. Could you transfer the file from her computer and deliver it to the courier when she comes? It'll be easy. You just wander over to their Animus, log in, and transfer the file. Easy. And please be snappy before I find a reason to hate you, too. A locked door. Not a problem. That's the advantage of me having level 1 security clearance. Now, you do, too. Don't abuse it. Log on, and I'll walk you through this. Now, you need to bypass the core to find the data inside. Once you reach it, your communicator will download it automatically. You need to find your way around the core to reach the data inside. You cracked it. Good. The file should be downloading. I set up a database for any data you find. Just look for the My File section in your communicator, and you'll be redirected right away. Everything you download will be found in there. Protected by a firewall, of course.
December 23rd, 2012. Sample Recovery Unit Team Lead Fisher Case reporting on Subject 17, Desmond Miles. The subject was deceased and unattended. Time of death was placed around 00 hours and 7 minutes, with conditions favorable for DNA sample recovery. We had some initial concerns about interference in the vault, but given the skill and talent of this team, we were able to capture useful data. I personally retrieved the subject's backpack and extracted a number of objects of interest to undergo detailed analysis. The subject displayed burns to the right hand, severe enough to fuse the bones, indicating some kind of spontaneous, intense burn trauma. Honestly, we've never seen anything like it before. Head, neck, and torso remained in good condition. I hand-selected recovery agents to retrieve fluid samples, blood and saliva. We then commenced material extraction and were able to preserve several exemplary samples. Data analysis and sequencing is already underway and, I'm told, proceeding with exceptional ease thanks to the cloud database and the work of Abstergo Sample Recovery Unit 3. The legacy of Subject 17 will continue uninhibited as Sample 17.
Oh, you're better at this than I'd hoped. Now zip on down to the lobby, come on. See, that file you acquired? I wouldn't recommend watching it. I mean, you could, but it's unpleasant. So once you hand it off, just pretend it never happened, okay? Otherwise, you'll just go to bed feeling sad. Anyway, the courier should be waiting downstairs. She's been here a while. I suppose it goes without saying, just because you now know how to hack all your colleagues' computers, it doesn't mean you should. I mean, not every day, right? No, seriously, though, that's illegal, so don't be a dick. Unless that's your nature.
I am not sure I can keep this up, you know? This job is well below my skill level.
Yeah, well, your coffee is shit. You could use some practice.
Oh, look who's here. So you didn't forget, after all. You're just incredibly rude and made poor Rebecca here wait for nearly 30 minutes.
You limey. Be nice. Sorry about him. He's high on his own supply. So, how should we do this? Data transfer? Great. That should do it. We'll email you the receipt. Till next time. Take care, Sean.
Bye-bye. Yes, bye. And don't expect any more free coffee. Arrogant. She's great, isn't she?
Hey, I just got word the courier has come and gone. Wonderful, you're a miracle. No, that's an exaggeration. You're not a miracle. You're an employee. Doing a job. But thanks for helping out. Anyway, thanks. Have fun pirating.
Assistance au niveau 2, projet échantillon 17. Support to the second floor, sample 17 project.